Hello there, Halal Integrated Platform or HIP, powered by Halal Development Corporation. It's a networking platform that connects to global halal ecosystem, equipping your business with a competitive edge. As a HIP member, you can engage internal HDC stakeholders and external strategy partners within the halal industry. So, what do you get as a HIP member? Here you go. You get financial facility, market access, human capital development, business capability development, and halal industry support and facilitation. How does industry players can utilize HIP? As a buyer, you can search halal products through our HIP database. As a service provider or financial institution, you can engage with halal industry players. For government agencies, you can offer initiatives and programs. Hey, venture capitalists and investors can also seek for unlisted company to invest. For halal professionals, you can access our database for halal ingredient sourcing. Finally, manufacturers and sellers, join us to promote your products and get connected to global supply chain. What are you waiting for? Join us for free as HIP member. Enjoy opportunities and exclusive access and increase visibility in halal industry. Let's go!
Malaysia's digital journey began more than two decades ago when MSC Malaysia was set up to transform the country into a knowledge-based economy. Since then, MSC Malaysia has contributed immensely towards the growth of the nation's digital economy. Our next step is to take the digital transformation from the corridor to the world. Introducing Malaysia Digital, a strategic initiative which will empower the rakyat, businesses and foreign investments. Malaysia Digital will also elevate the participation of Malaysians and local businesses in revolutionizing the world's digital economy. Malaysia Digital opens doors for Malaysians by providing equitable access to digital tools, knowledge, and income opportunities. It offers new business opportunities and growth through a supportive digital ecosystem. It also provides flexible and agile investment facilitation to make the country investment friendly. The goal is to drive the digital ecosystem and develop the digital economy to a stage where it contributes at least 25.5% of our GDP and creates 500,000 jobs by 2025.
Malaysia Digital will galvanize public-private partnerships to accelerate the growth of our digital economy and drive positive transformation that ultimately benefit the rakyat, businesses, investors, and also the whole nation.
Establishing Malaysia into a digital nation, one with more adept, stronger and resilient economy, society and governance. Stepping into tomorrow's digital future today.
Hello, apa khabar semua? Assalamualaikum, I am Shilda Ismail and welcome to our third episode of Tea and Tech HYP live talk show. Well, it's a thematic and episodic talk show, a series of aspiring techpreneurs and founders will be sharing their journey in helping users and users in the name of Rakyat and Ummah as a whole. Well, this is a collaboration between HGC and MDEC and HYP and of course the Islamic Digital Economy to showcase Malaysia as a global hub, maturing Islamic finance and halal ecosystem backed by strong talent and Sharia experts. Hence, we need to give a shout out. We need to hoo-ha these people to our founders and those who have been very, very instrumental in this sphere. So for the next few episodes throughout this year, I shall be co-hosting none other with Roslina Ramli, Director of FinTech and Islamic Digital Economy of MDEC. Hi, Roslina.
Lena. Everybody, welcome to our episode 3.
Okay, episode 3. Lena, tell the audience what is Tea and Tech is all about.
Okay, so Tea and Tech is an idea that was mooted between my shoulder. So the two of us got together in support of amplifying successful Malaysian technology companies that have supported our digitalization journey. So within MDEC, we have got close to about 3,000 technology companies. Yep. So we are in support of trying to encourage more Malaysian companies to join our Malaysia Digital, or MD for short, initiatives as we revolutionize Malaysia to become a successful digital nation. So specifically under Islamic Digital Economy, the profiling is looking at key pillars within the halal supply chain, which falls in very nicely with Halal Development Corp and the other initiatives that MDEC is currently ongoing in support of trying to further galvanize more market access as well as success stories.
Right. Okay, thank you so much, Lena. And today we have a very special star, I have to call them star, also founder stars, okay? And we have here Encik Mazri Mahat, Chief Executive Officer, Sinsor Sdn Bhd. Encik Mazri, all the way from KK. Assalamualaikum.
Matt, we can't hear you. You're mute.
Yeah, you muted. You have to switch on your mic.
Sorry. Assalamualaikum, Hajar, Roslina, Shilda. Thank you for having me.
All right. We're going to talk about Halal Assurance System in a digitalized method. Okay. Next, we have also an industry player who's been in the industry for many, many years, and Encik Shukri Ibrahim, Director of Islamic Affairs and Government Relations, Mami Double Decker Malaysia Sdn Bhd. He'll be speaking the scenarios of halal industry. Assalamualaikum, Encik Shukri.
Waalaikumsalam, waalaikumsalam. Sida, how are you, Sida, and how the audience there? So hopefully today we'll be sharing of the information and also we can help our country to improve the halal of the
industry
ecosystem in the world.
Correct.
Okay, let's do it.
Let's do it. Okay, but before we start, since the name of our show is actually Teh and Tech, Teh represent the halal industry, Tech represents IDE, Islamic Digital Economy and MDEC. So let's raise our cups ataupun our mug. But actually, I'm drinking coffee lah.
Yes.
All right. Bismillah. All right. First of all, I would like to ask Encik Shukri. So, you know, tell me generally in terms of halal industry, in terms of halal assurance systems, you know, to the normal people, they might not understand. But in the industry, HAS is pretty much your word of jargons lah. You've been in the industry for the last 20 years, betul Encik Shukri?
Yeah, in the industry 20 years, but handling of the halal, mommy, 12 years already.
Oh, 20 years, mashallah. Okay, perhaps you can also tell
me. 20
years
with industries, yeah.
With the industry. Perhaps you can tell me what is it important in terms of halal assurance system and tell me a little bit more about your background, Encik Shukri. Silakan.
Okay, my name is Ahmad Shukri bin Ibrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. I was working with the Mami Double Decker since 2002. Now, currently, I'm holding on of the position of the Director of Islamic Affairs and Government Relations. That my job is specifically to handle of this halal ecosystem in Mami. Yeah? In Mami Group, there I have to handle of the four plants in Malaysia. Subang, located in Subang, Melaka, Kuantan, and also Johor. So all the plants is already certified halal by JAKIM. and also we have our dedicated candidate ataupun what we call is the halal executive. It's every plant. But talking about the halal assurance system, talking about the halal assurance, we make it clear here. Halal assurance system is a it's an arranged apply and also the maintenance system by halal certified company like us, like Mami, to maintain sustainability of halal production process according to the rules of our authority, is checking.
Okay.
This is the thing that the whole industry must be understand. Why the halal assurance system established by JAKIM? That JAKIM would like us to establish our system in our internal halal management. Okay, so we have to follow the halal assurance system created by JAKIM or developed by JAKIM, and also they share the knowledge with the industries lah. The halal assurance system also is a systematic approach to identify the halal of non-contamination. Any non-contamination, this halal assurance system that will be the main reference, and also the control measure to ensure the halal and the safety status of a product and services. So must be understand that halal assurance system very important to the industry to ensure that we follow all the requirement stated in the halal assurance system. It is implementation is beneficial for company as a continuous improvement to ensure the integrity of the halal, the integrity, the soul of the halal, of the product and services once the principle of the halal are implemented. So all the industry must be understand that if you have the soul of the halal, so we involve with the halal, then we have to follow all the requirements and regulations set by the authority. Okay, it's JAKIM lah. And also the halal assurance system will also set out six principles. What is the six principle? Number one is the determination of the halal critical point. This is the halal assurance system. Number two, development and verification of flow chart. What's our flow chart of our process? We have to develop and verification internally. Number three, implementation of control measure. This is important of the halal assurance system. Number four, development of corrective action. This is every halal executive, every company, every candidate or every person who are involved with the halal must know how to develop of the corrective measure, control measure in your factory process area. Number four, development of corrective action. How we want to do some improvement to our non-conformance. Okay. Number five, a documentation system and management of the record. This is important thing because of sometimes the record, whatever thing that we are keeping in our laptop, sometimes, sometimes we can refer back for our future use. But how about the record that we keep in the file as a manual method? So sometimes the file is missing or whatever thing happened to the file, though we cannot find it.
Yeah.
Okay? Number six, the one is the process of verification. The process of verification is usually we refer to the manual file also. We keep all the file, all the documentation in our manual file. Suddenly the file is missing. Suddenly the file, we don't know who keep. So this is a big trouble for the industry. This happened to Mami also before. So now we have to think about how we want to improve our system internally by might be. And then we already discussed among our team. We will involve with the digitalization of the keeping the record. So this one I have an idea and a contact and also discussion with the person or with the body that can help us in terms of the improvement of this keeping of record using the digital method. So we think that this one is for the long term use. This is good for us to manage our halal compliance, halal certification, all the plant in Malaysia. Thank you, Sida. Yeah. I think this is a little bit from me. Maybe we may continue after this. Okay.
This is the reason why, Cik Shukri, we want you to explain because you've been in the 20 years and you mentioned the documentation lah, hilang lah, dia punya data dan sebagainya. These are some of the human errors or the what do you call that, the situational analysis that, and that's why that we come up. Since I come up with a digitalized, a systematic HAS. Okay, for that, can we have a Cik Mazri to explain what is CoreHalal about? What is HIP Pro digitalizing halal assurance system? Go ahead, Mac.
Thank you, Shilda. So, in terms of the background CoreHalal, we started the journey of CoreHalal back in 2020 as one of the Cradle Fund Mahackathon program participant. And then, alhamdulillah, we managed to get the government grant to further improve CoreHalal. And again, we received a second round of grant from them last year to further improve CoreHalal system. So the main idea behind CoreHalal is actually we want to tackle the three pain points. So the first one is actually we are having a lack of accredited halal executive versus the market demand. So we have about, based on the SME Corp latest information, we have about 200,000 SME or micro SME that are working or producing a halal product and services. And we only have about 6,000 halal executive, accredited halal executive. Mm-hmm. We want to close this gap. And then the second pain point that we want to tackle is actually the visibility of the whole halal process supply chain. That is very lacking in the industry right now. That's why we sometimes heard about the meat cartel, the fake logo, halal logo, and so forth.
Yes.
And then finally, the third pain point that we try to tackle is actually the lack of information on how to get halal certified, how to get halal certification, because everyone have their own version of, oh, you need to get this file, you need to get this documentation, this and that. So we actually introducing like a centralized digital template and digital tools for the micro SME and the SME to make the journey of getting the halal certificate very easy and very fast for them. So that's why we introduced a halal assurance system. So why CoreHalal? Actually, the objective of CoreHalal is actually we want to give these four things to the SME, especially to the micro SME. We want them to be halal certified or at least halal ready. And then the second one is by having a halal certification or halal ready businesses, they will also be export ready. So right in today's like Shopee and Lazada, you know, we are not talking about exporting ton or container of item, like 1 or 2 kilo of product you can simply export to overseas, right? And then the third one is actually we want the SME or micro SME to be compliance ready, not just for halal but for HACCP and GMP, because this is especially important if they want to export to, say, European country. So they need the HACCP and GMP as a very bare minimum requirement. And finally, with the integration with Halal Integrated Platform and HIP Pro, we want to give them the market access and business networking. So we want the business halal business player in Malaysia to connect to Australia, to Japan, and then maybe do a business exchange of business and so forth. So in a nutshell, CoreHalal is all about to help the SME and the micro SME to get the halal process in place in their company. And then we want to make sure that the halal executive, we want to empower the halal executive and the halal certified business to diligently manage their halal operation by using a digitalization tool like CoreHalal.
Okay, thank you so much, Mac. Okay, Mac is actually live from KK. Mac, okay, this is really interesting where our techpreneurs can actually be everywhere and still develop very, very good products. Okay, Lina, what do you think about digitalizing HAS? How does it, give a different, it becomes a market trend in terms of halal industry, Lina? And what do you think of CoreHalal?
Before I go into what I think about CoreHalal, I want to reiterate balik what Mazuri just shared with us. So, you know, I think it's important for everyone to understand what is the problem statement that we are trying to solve. So number one, as we mentioned about authentication of halal products and services, that's one. Two, authentication, and this also includes authentication of products, right, of ingredients as well. And then you want to also try to resolve problems with regards to the contamination of halal products in transit as well. That's two. So three is of course, how can we speed turnaround time of our halal JAKIM certification as well as the review. So these are some of the three key areas that we're trying to do, and that is what HIP is trying to help resolve as an industry collective effort. So, and CoreHalal is one of the technology solutions that, you know, Alhamdulillah, MDEC has helped to try to profile in support of resolving these three core problem statements. So ultimately, it would be, it is a fabulous initiative because there is a collaboration between, you know, not just with several government agencies. So you've got MDEC, you've got HTC, you also have got JAKIM as well, in support of ensuring that Malaysia's prominence as the halal hub is featured holistically together as one nation, right? So the dream for Islamic digital economy, especially for our halal side, is for Malaysia to be that hotbed of proof of concepts for everything and anything that's got to do halal. So I said earlier, so you've got dashboards, you've got IoT, you've got traceability. So if we can tell the world, if you have problem statements with regards to halal, come to Malaysia because our technology companies can resolve them. Yeah. And you also got HIP to help support market demand for products and services in support of trying to create more market traction for meeting the needs of consumer demands for Muslim products. So that's the wrap up for all.
Inshallah. Okay, Lena, perhaps, Shukri, perhaps you can also tell me with regards to, you know, you're very familiar with Halal Executive. How does, you know, digital halal assurance and can assist or ease a lot of issues, you know, among the Halal Executive? Can you give me an example, you know, scenarios that happen with Halal Executive in the traditional, the conventional versus digital? Silakan, Encik Shukri. Okay.
Berdasarkan pengalaman, based on our experience before that, what we are practice right now actually, but before we enter to the digital method of the control, the documents, everything, we have a big problem in terms of the control, the documentation. Because the documentation is very important for us to maintain it for our record to show to the auditor, especially from Jabatan Agama Islam Negeri, or even though Jabatan Kemajuan Islam Malaysia, JAKIM, and also sometimes we also involve with the international body of halal certification like Indonesia certification from MUI. So this is the issue that we have to maintain it in according to the their needs. So sometimes our staff or our internal people here, they are lack of the controlling the document for long term. Means that they only focus that the documents only for the short term. How about the long term? If keep a long term, there will be space constraint.
Okay? Yes.
Kekurangan tempat untuk penyimpanan. This is the thing that we have for problem. So what we do is we just save in the system, in the laptop, our laptop. But sometimes the laptop also hang jam, or sometimes the laptop also
big act and sebagainya.
Missing document. So that's what we need to think about, something that better that can be used for long term. This is the thing that we need, some of the system or the apps can be help us to run the halal certification in our company smoothly and also can use for the long term. So for the industry who would like to change their method of the manage one of the halal in the company, I insist them, I recommend them to think about to change the method to the digitalized of the system. So outside that,
so
I think as this is also my MDEC also offers in the for the industry, many of the method of a system can be used for our halal industry in our company. Okay.
Yes.
Go ahead.
I want to just tambah from what Encik Shukri just shared. And I think it's really great to see, you know, Malaysian champions like Mami in support of trying to onboard digitalization. And I think that's fabulous. So, you know, we will, MDEC, we will be very pleased to have Mami as our Malaysian digital champion and see how we can further onboard more Thank technology you. Solutions, selain daripada Mazri, you know, other technology. If you need dashboards, IoTs, how can we further strengthen your value proposition and tell the world that you are our digital champion for the digitalization of the halal supply chain?
Inshallah. Yeah. Thank you so much for the heads up. Also,
Lena.
Okay, since we were talking about HIP Pro powered by CoreHalal, perhaps, Mazri, I can't even, although I work for HIP, I've been in the HIP Pro, but, you know, can you explain us, illustrate to us extensively on HIP Pro powered by CoreHalal? Silakan. Give us your live presentation.
Before I demo the system. Actually, I just want to reiterate balik apa yang Cik Shukri mentioned tadi. I think Halal Assurance System ni is a requirement by the certification body, but the term of the Halal Assurance System tu, why we want to use the Halal Assurance System is actually we want to have the systematic approach of identifying or managing the non-halal contamination. And on the same time, we want to make sure the SME know the process of halal operation from end to end. So the halalness to on the ownership of halalness owned by the SME itself. So before I show the demo of the system, maybe I just little bit share about the MHMS 2020, which is the document by guideline by JAKIM. Let me share my screen.
Actually, I really like the name of CoreHalal, Lena. It goes to show it's solving the issues, the core issues.
We don't reinvent the wheel. Actually, the guideline, the processes is already there, provided by JAKIM. So if you look at this diagram that I show, MHMS 2020 or Malaysia Halal Management System document guideline ataupun sistem jaminan halal, they already define the requirement of what are the things that you need to have in your HAS or Halal Assurance System. So normally without digitalization, you need to do manually the HAS, manual HAS lah, Halal Assurance System. So there's 1 to 10 point that you need to have as part of your HAS manual. So what CoreHalal did was we digitalized the whole thing from 1 to 10 into a digital system. So we have the halal policy, halal risk control, so to all digitalized into a cloud system. And then we also need to know that HAS is only meant for the SME, but the big chunk of the halal business producer in Malaysia are the micro SME. So micro SME, they don't have to use the Halal Assurance System, but they need to have their own internal halal control system or sistem kawalan halal, dalaman halal. So if the SME need to adhere to the 10 point that I mentioned just now, for internal halal control system, they only to have these 4 item lah, I call it as an item, in their internal halal control system. So it's very easy, it's very simple actually. And then by right, if you properly adhere to all these 4 points, you should have your halal operation in place, and there's no reason for you to not getting the halal certificate or to maintain the halal certification. So the definition of micro SME I mentioned dekat bawah tu, copy paste daripada SME Corp. So basically for certain category, they have they need to reach certain revenue in order to become SME, but before that they will be part of the micro SME. So what we did after we add in all the Halal Assurance System, kita tambah a little bit of value added modules inside our halal digital halal assurance system to make sure that this additional module will help them in terms of running their daily operation, because some of the most important things that they need to do is actually they need to capture their purchasing of raw material. Sebab raw material ni is quite critical, because they need to purchase from halal source of raw material, and then they need to update they need to know who are the supplier is, they need to record all this invoicing and so forth. And then if they want to get the certification for their premises, they need to manage their premises, their product as well, they need to update. And finally, they can have their own halal database inside the system. And then this will in turn will help them to not just for the halal process, but also on their daily operation. So let me show you the system. Sekejap ya, saya tengah stream.
And Cik Shukri, you have any questions with regards to HRP Pro?
So far, okay. Actually, during our meeting previously that explained by your teams,
okay,
really understand all the function and also the benefit of this system. so far, I would like to encourage all the company.
Yeah. Do you think it's easy? It's easy for
this
your
is very easy to use. Yes. Our HE very happy about this system. And they are the system is really orang kata user friendly,
user friendly.
So it's easy for us to control and monitor, and they also can access anytime and also everywhere. We can show to our authority during the audit audit that performed by our authority also. It's easy and then easy to understand, easy to learn, easy to control also.
Also cheap.
Trust me. Not as expensive, it's cheap.
Okay, go ahead,
Matt,
silakan.
Just to add Cik Shukri punya point tadi, actually when we go back to our user, right, I think one of the biggest challenge for them to use any system, not just CoreHalal, is actually to sit down in front of the computer and update all this information. Because as you know, especially F&B, there are
200 SKUs.
They are very busy, like dekat dapur, you know, dekat cafe. So they don't even have time to, you know, to update all these things. So what we do is actually we develop our system as responsive as possible. You can use even like iPad to update all the temperature, all the, you know, all the SKU, all the raw material and so forth. So you can simply update everything, all the information on the fly while you are working dekat dalam lift, you know, updating while going to the meeting and so forth. Because we try not to be a system that you can only update lepas you balik office depan computer, because we understand that all this user is actually not the people that always in front of the laptop. So there will be always like, you know, chef, sous chef, cooking, memasak, you know, all these people. So they need to have a system that very compatible, that very responsive. So this is our HIP Pro, Halal Assurance System. So once you go into the HIP Pro, the first thing that you will see is actually not the halal part. It's actually the processing, the daily operation part. How much you are purchasing today, the raw material. What is the latest of your invoicing or your receipt? So, and then you will see the top here is the halal assurance summary. How many critical point you already identify, the countermeasure that the one that Encik Shukri mentioned about the halal assurance system need to have the 6 principle. And then here you will see your how many halal certificate. Kalau your halal certificate is about to expire or already expired, the system will actually give a notification to you that you need to do something to update. So
it will notify through the email, right? Encik Mike,
Exactly.
Encik Mazri, So
the first category here is actually the one that is already described as part of the system jaminan halal. You have the company profile, you have the halal policy, you have all the halal committee and everything. So you don't have to use your Microsoft Word or anything. You just edit on the fly from here. So from here is actually you can, edit all your documentation and all your scope and policy. And towards the end, later on, you can simply download the PDF format or Word format. And then this will be part of your audit process or your certification process. So everything is actually as per the flow from MHMS 2020. We have also halal SOP, internal halal audit, halal risk control, up to traceability and so forth. So what we give to the user or to the SME is actually the template, the digital template. So they don't have to find or macam mana nak define halal risk control. What is internal halal audit? We give them the sample, so it's up to them based on their discussion with halal executive and their ISC to define the right policy for their company. And then we also have halal assurance. So halal assurance, again, we have a critical point, everything in place. We have the process flow, control measure, corrective action and so forth. So all this is actually interrelated with each other. Critical point will find the right control measure, and then if anything happen, what will be the corrective action that you need to do. And then we have form. So form is quite important as well. So this is where you will update your batch management, meaning how many product you are producing. And also you can even register your NCR here. So non-conformance report, you don't have to use a digital form. Pakai kita punya system, you can register your NCR with the corrective action record. So everything is digitalized. So even you have your own cloud system, like Google Drive or Dropbox. And then this is where we have the additional value-added module. So you can manage your supplier, you can manage your raw material. And then with that supplier, what are the raw material that they are supplying? And then you can record your invoice and receipt inside this purchasing module. And then from that purchasing, what are the raw material that you purchase? And this is the premises that you need to update if you want to go into, if you want to get your premise certified with all the document list that you need to have. So if you don't have this document, you can't really, submit to get the certification. So we have everything in place for them. And then finally, you can manage your certificate here. Like Encik Shukri again mentioned just now, not just for Jakim, you can have a certification from Indonesia or from Australia. So you can register from here as well. And finally, you have your own halal database. So whatever that you enter into the system, you can search from here. So for example, maybe 3 months ago, ada beli daripada supplier A, tapi you don't know mana nak cari, you just search from here, you can get all the information. And this is all the PDF, all the generated document that will help you in term of audit and submission for halal certification. It's very easy. Just like that, you comply with your halal assurance process and also on the same time helping you with the daily operation.
Masri, if you could also show how you could ping the halal executive if there is a renewal for Jakim certification. I think that's superb.
Yeah. So for example, this one, right? I mean, katakanlah this one dah expired lah, kan? So it will automatically. Oh, sorry. Hari bulan. Certificate.
And to all our audience, AMDAG is in discussion with Jakim as well in to support of how we can further seamlessly share this information between the respective government agencies and help facilitate more technology digital adoptions to ease, companies like Mami as they continue to onboard more SKUs into their ecosystem.
And also, Mazri, I would like to ask, I want to add something here. This system also will trigger to halal executive any of the notification that, example, certification halal that will be expired in the future. They will trigger to the halal executive, is it? Through the
Exactly. Yes. So this is very easy because this is one of the most sought after feature that we get from the industry. That's boleh tak you remind kita orang kalau kita orang punya sijil dah nak expire ataupun dah expire. So for example, I just change the expiry validity just now, so you will get this and you will also get the email. So meaning to say, if you don't do anything within few days, we will spam you an email so until you do something about it. So it's like, so you need to do this because this is very critical. This already break the halal process in the company.
Yes, correct.
So no alasan really not renewing your halal certification because there's so many spamming and also reminders.
This thing always happen in the industry.
Always in the industry
that we are not aware about the halal certification of the raw material expired. During the audit session, then sudah expired, sudah not valid anymore. So that's why we kena non-conformance from. This is one of the example. They have another example that weakness from the old system, the manual system that practiced in the company right now.
Just to add that, Encik Shukri, I think with the collaboration with HIP, because HIP, they have this raw ingredient database. So what we will have is actually when they want to source for raw material later on, so we can connect with the HIP raw material database. So they can get all the information, they can ensure that the raw material is halal and they have a proper documentation, then they can use for their operation.
Yeah, it is actually an ecosystem. And for that, Cik Mazi, is it that? Is it? Are you done? Are you completed? Yep. Okay. So I'm also going to actually invite our business and also IT analyst for HIP to further demonstrate and also illustrate what's with regards to HIP Pro and how does it help in terms of a business. As you mentioned just now, the halal ingredient, etc. How do you search? You know, the specific halal ingredients from the suppliers. Mizi, are you ready?
I'm ready. Hello, hi okay. Everyone.
Hi, okay, go ahead, Mizi. Share your insights. Okay, go ahead.
All right, so for everyone information, HIP Pro is designed to empower halal executive in halal industry. So on top of having our digital halal assurance system in HIP Pro, we also have other features that can support your business by providing additional features that required by halal executive and also your company management, right? Okay. So HIP Pro has 6 other elements, including halal ingredient database, halal business directory, data analytics and dashboard, access to product halal certificate, additional business details, and also search and analytics report. Right, so on the halal regulatory perspective, we have our halal ingredient database and halal business directory. So user can use the directory in finding contact information for organization, for halal executive information and also PIC information. So this can be used and this can be very helpful when you are trying to reach out to potential partners, suppliers, and also your customers. All right, so other than that, user can also have access to product halal certificates in HIP database. So, yep, we try to help the user in sourcing for halal products for their market study. And, yep, from the business perspective, user can have extra access in search and analytics report. So the data will be obtained from HIP members database. So user can leverage search and analytics report businesses and also can gain a competitive advantage and drive growth and profitability. Yep, that's from business perspective side in HIP Pro.
Okay, thank you so much, Hamizi. All right, so we have come almost at the end of the show. Lina, perhaps you can give a little bit of, you know, what do you think about digitalizing, simplifying HAS, simplifying the halal industry, especially for the halal executive, empowering halal executive.
Great. So, I mean, as you know, the whole world has had to pivot to digitalization, and that's across all the various sectors that you see. So through enablement of digital, we are seeing faster turnaround of products, for halal products coming on stream. And, you know, Mac is one of the Masri, our founder, among the founders that we have helped to profile, not just locally, but also abroad with the help of HGC juga. So how can we further strengthen the value proposition of digitalization? And you all heard from Encik Shukri. You know, dulu you have to do everything semua manual. So right now, yeah, using platform, apps, how can we further strengthen? And as you know, with economies of scale, and I'm telling all this to all my ecosystem partners, don't try to reinvent the wheel. Onboard our technology, award-winning technology companies in support of your digitalization journey. So bersama-sama dengan MDEC and also HTC untuk membangunkan our digitalization agenda and ecosystem. And our continued mantra for MDEC is always to be that ecosystem builder. So how can we further strengthen more companies, not just Mami, but other MNCs? You know, if you read news from HTC, there are about 40 plus multinational companies that are located in Malaysia. So how can we outreach to them, strengthen our value proposition for OEMs within Malaysia or Malaysian companies, and also onboard technology companies? So we hit two birds in one stone. So there's a lot more ongoing concerted efforts that are currently happening on the ground, and we will be happy to further, you know, update our concerted efforts together in support of T and Tech's future episodes.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much, Lena. All right. That's all we have for today's episode, Digitalizing Halal Assurance System. But for that, perhaps, Encik Shukri and also Mazri, you can give a word of advice or word of wisdom. Encik Shukri, kita start dengan orang lama dulu.
Word of wisdom?
Yeah, word of wisdom.
Baca belakang saya.
Ah, itu dah. Understanding people is not a waste of time.
Okay, understanding of people are not a waste of time. But understanding of the method of the system also, not human.
Yeah,
people betul. Is people. It's a system, is we have to understand the system. Now the technology is berubah-ubah. It changes every year. So now the digitalization platform is very good for the company who want to improve their system of the halal management system in their company. Because the let us think about the digital transformation. If you're not involved in this digital transformation, we will be ketinggalan.
Betul.
Kita bukan nak backward, kita nak forward. Let the company to be expand, maju ke hadapan. That's why the SMEs or MNC, like Mami is a localized company, LLC, that we for the early of the halal established in Mami since 2000, not mistaken, for around that, since the Jakim take over the certification, we established the department, this halal department. Previously, we don't have the specific department of the halal. Then from there, we think about to focus in the halal ecosystem business, okay? So because of the halal business, our Mami business and auto profit keep increase every year. And then now our profit margin can say that keep naik, going up, even though the price raw material also menaik.
Increasing.
So, but our business, we are focusing on local and also the export market. 80 countries of export market, Mami involved. And then also our revenue is 1.3 billion last year. So this is because of the halal ecosystem, halal business that we involved previously. So hopefully that with this system, like HIP introduced to the industry, I believe that our halal management system in our company can be improved and can be kemaskan lagi. So we try to reduce any of non-conformance, okay?
Yeah.
Non-conformance issue in our company by using this system of digital. So tak ada salahnya. There have no any of the mistake that we choose this. Why not we try? We are within 1 year. What is going on within 1 year? Might be our system of the halal will be much better compared than before. Before this, we use a manual type. After this, we evolve in the digital type. We transform the method to the digital. Then I believe that it's much better. So I encourage all the industry outside there, please join this method of the digital transformation for our benefit and for our halal ecosystem in our country. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Cik Shukri. Okay, Cik Mazri, what do you think about, you know, what Cik Shukri has mentioned? This is somehow it's a market trend. It's it's somehow helping the halal executive, helping at the same time helping the halal industry. Like you, one thing in particular, the notification of the CJ Halal itu sangat-sangat penting because, you know, kita understanding human being is not a waste of time. Manusia ni selalu lupa, betul tak, Encik Shukri? So this is somehow another aspect that we need to resolve, kan,
Encik? One thing I want to add in the industry also, my company, Mami here. Mami also, we transform all the department to digital.
Okay, digital method. Right?
Why not halal department also transform it to digital?
Yeah, betul.
Right, this is the thing that we have to think about halal ecosystem in our company. Yeah. Information technology, IT department, finance, purchasing, human resource. Why not HR? Why not halal?
So our
halal, we have to strengthen it. Join this digital platform. So please come and join this digital platform.
Thank you so much. Okay. Okay. All right. Teruskan, Cik Mazri.
Okay.
Cik Mazri, kata-kata.
I just want to echo what Haja Roslina and Cik Shukri mentioned just now. I think digitalization is everywhere nowadays. Yeah. And disruption is actually just around the corner for any industry. I've seen it 5 years ago in the legal industry. Now we have legal tech, regulatory tech. And halal is just the next industry that will be disrupted by the digitalization. So I think what we have, what CoreHalal have, is actually we are very thankful with all the government agency like MDEC, HDC, even Cradle, even from the Sabah state. So we are really, really thankful because of all this full support from the government agency, because I believe they see the importance of to be ahead in terms of halal digitalization, because we are number one right now, but how we want to keep to be, you know, to be at the top in terms of the digitalization, especially on the halal and also on the Islamic fintech. So I think for us, we want to introduce something new to the industry, but on the same time, we need to be very careful on how the market adoption, because for example, like one example I mentioned just now is all these people that will be used CoreHalal is very busy. They're always at the kitchen, the cafe, and so forth.
Yeah.
How they can input the data into the system. So we have to improvise. We have to make it very responsive. So that's how we actually tackle the issue of digitalization in terms of the halal industry. We want to have a system yang memang diorang nak guna. Memang bukan just to have the system yang only like every once a week nak update and so forth. We want them to use like they use Facebook, Instagram, yeah, every day. They need to update this. So we aim to be that kind of system, because eventually we want to help them to get to on the halal process, and also on the same time, everything is digitalized, traceable, and follow through the gold standard that JAKIM already provide for us. And on the same time, we can export this process to the overseas. And we can say like, look, we have the halal digital process in place. Why don't you use the same high standard that we have? So that's the target for CoreHalal. Yep.
This one also can be limits human error also. This is
yes. Yes.
And also they can increase operational of efficiency.
Better.
Our system. These two elements very important. Human error and also to increase operational efficiency. These yep. two things, if you can manage it, then your halal system memang perfect lah.
Inshallah.
The value proposition is the cost competitiveness of the entry point. You don't need to reinvent the wheel. That means you spend capex.
Yeah.
You engage aja dengan Mazri CoreHalal in support of your dashboard initiatives.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much, guys. On behalf of HIP HDC, we would encourage you guys to be our members of HIP. You can log on to HIP.HDC.
I hope that industry can open their mind.
Okay.
Talk about how authority needs. Kita kena fikir. We have to think what is authority need. Authority needs how you control the system, halal system in your company. So this system also, what we can say is increase authority satisfaction. You know.
Yeah.
Once they come and audit you, you show to them that your initiative to maintain all the information or record that you have by using yes. this digital platform, then they will you will impress them lah. You click saja every all the information yeah. they can show you through the screen. It's yep. easy.
Correct.
True.
So halal executive lepas ni goyang kaki saja kata.
Okay, thank you. All right, thank you so much, Encik Shukri. I think we need to have a part two with Encik Shukri sahaja to speak on halal industry. Kan, we have Encik Shukri. All right, okay. That's all we have for our TNTech episode 3. And I would like to say thank you again to MDEC, who has been, hugely significant in the role of Islamic digital economy and, of course, in fintech and also in halal economy. Thank you so much, Encik Shukri, for all your insights and also of your excitement to be part in this discussion, your experience, your insights. Ini sangat-sangat penting ya untuk for the betterment. Because kalau daripada CoreHalal, dia akan develop dia punya apps ataupun system. Right. Tetapi daripada industry player to be speaking this is really, really, terima kasih lah. Thank you so much. And thank you so much, Mazri, and also Mizi, for your ideas and also your core values and mission to serve our halal players. Dan akhirnya kita akan, in the bigger ecosystem, kita akan berjaya di mata dunia. Okay? That's all from me, Lena. It has been a pleasure. Assalamualaikum. Thank you so much.
Waalaikumsalam. Thank you, everybody. It was an absolute pleasure.
Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Mizi, and today I'll be showing you on how you can register with HIP. Let's go!
First, you need to register your account at hip.hdcglobal.com. Fill in your email, password, and don't forget to tick the box before you proceed. Click Get Started. Success! Next, fill in your personal details on the user profile page and click Update. Success! Most importantly, fill in all information of your company on the business profile page and click Update. Success! Don't forget to fill in the organization information and click Update. Success! Complete your products and services listing here so that your range of products is visible, and here is the example of a completed business profile. And we are done. Easy, isn't it? Register as HIP member and accelerate your business with HDC.
Malaysia's digital journey began more than two decades ago when MSC Malaysia was set up to transform the country into a knowledge-based economy. Since then, MSC Malaysia has contributed immensely towards the growth of the nation's digital economy. Our next step is to take the digital transformation from the corridor to the world. Introducing Malaysia Digital, a strategic initiative which will empower the rakyat, businesses, and foreign investments. Malaysia Digital will also elevate the participation of Malaysians and local businesses in revolutionizing the world's digital economy. Malaysia Digital opens doors for Malaysians by providing equitable access to digital tools, knowledge, and income opportunities. It offers new business opportunities and growth through a supportive digital ecosystem. It also provides flexible and agile investment facilitation to make the country investment friendly. The goal is to drive the digital ecosystem and develop the digital economy to a stage where it contributes at least 25.5% of our GDP and creates 500,000 jobs by 2025.
Malaysia Digital will galvanize public-private partnerships to accelerate the growth of our digital economy and drive positive transformation that ultimately benefit the rakyat, businesses, investors, and also the whole nation.
Establishing Malaysia into a digital nation, one with more adept, stronger, and resilient economy, society, and governance. Stepping into tomorrow's digital future today.
Bye.